Hello students, today we are going to study about leaves. There are two types of leaves present on the plants. One is simple leaf and another one is compound leaf. Many leaves together on a simple single twig is called compound leaf, and one leaf only present on one twig is called simple leaf. Let's discuss about the different parts of a leaf. Leaf is usually green because of the presence of chlorophyll in that. The flat blade-like structure of the leaf is called leaf blade or lamina. The pointed corner part is called tips or apex. The sides are called margin. The middle thick vein is called midrib, while the smaller side veins are called veins or side veins. The base of the leaf joining it with the stem is called petiole. Each leaf contains few openings on the lower surface, which is called stomata. Stomata helps in the exchange of gases. Like in photosynthesis, plants need carbon dioxide, which enters through these stomatas, and they leave oxygen, which comes out of these stomatas only. During respiration, these stomatas help to take in oxygen and leave the carbon dioxide out. Here comes the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the food making process of a green plant. With the help of light or sunlight, the green plants take in carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and uses the water from the roots, which have been absorbed by the roots from the soil. This water and this carbon dioxide, they both react with each other in the presence of light, and green color pigment, which is called chlorophyll, present in the green plants, and it prepares the food for the plants and leaves oxygen in the atmosphere. That is why we always say to plant more and more trees, because after the process of photosynthesis, the leftover oxygen is useful for the animal kingdom. Here is the equation of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of light and chlorophyll, it prepares glucose or food and oxygen for the atmosphere. Another question comes in the mind. Why the leaves turn yellow, or why the leaves change their color during the winters? This is because in winters there is less of sunlight, which does not let the plants to flourish well. That is why the leaves change their color, because of the less of sunlight and less of the workings. Here you can see and you can observe the change in color. The green dark is turning into lighter, then turning into pale, and finally it is getting dry. Here comes to the part of the interdependence of plants and animals. The plants produce oxygen and fruit, food for the animal world. Animals take in the food made by the plants, as well as they breathe in the oxygen thrown out by the plants during the process of photosynthesis. While animals release carbon dioxide during the respiration, and which is used by the plants to make their food or the sugar molecules. Here comes the food chain. Each plant and animal is dependent, we have already studied. Now, green plants, suppose one animal is dependent on the another animal, this is called food chain. Here the energy flow as well as food flow can be observed. There is a tree, a deer. Suppose a deer is an herbivorous animal. Herbivorous animal is dependent directly on the plants, while a carnivorous animal, a lion, is dependent on a herbivorous animal. So each animal or plant, indirectly or directly, they depend on each other. Most of the organisms, in fact all the animals, are directly or indirectly dependent on the green plants. Here another example is there. Flowers, hibiscus flowers, you can see here. The butterflies, They are sucking nectar out of them. Frogs are able to eat butterflies. Snake is eating frog and eagle is eating snake. So you can again see eagle is dependent on snake, snake is dependent on frog, frog is dependent on butterfly and butterfly is dependent on flower. So directly or indirectly, eagle is also dependent on flower. Now next, again you can see another example, flowers or the green grass. Small fishes are eating those green grasses, they are dependent on green plants. Larger fishes are eating small fishes and the birds like crane, they are eating the fishes. So directly or indirectly, what we can say, the tertiary animal, the third animal in the food chain, is also dependent on the plant. Thank you for today. That's all for the session of leaves. Stay tuned, we'll be meeting with the next topic soon.